No way, dog. There's no way. It truly is that time for another video here today. How is your boy, Toon Taylour? I'm here for episodes 262 and 263 of Fairy Tale. Whew. Last time I watched Fairy Tale, what did happen? Margear basically explained that END is the sole reason to everything. They're going to free him so he can kill Zeref, which only fuels the fire to believe that Natsu is END. Because every time Zeref shows up, he's like, Natsu, you're not strong enough yet. So what else would make sense than Natsu is END? Fire Demon, trained by Igneal. Fire Demon, trained by Igneal. Meant to kill Zeref. Zeref keeps showing up, telling him he's not strong enough yet. I don't know what to say. Makarov has basically called the guild to awaken the Luminous War, which is Master Mavis. And he asked Mest, once this whole thing is done, erase every nigga's memories. Oh yeah, and Mr. Foolbuster, gray, not silver, showed up and said, I'm him, dog. I'ma just freeze you. So yeah, we about to jump on in here real quick. Like, also the Sabertooth Master back, but who cares? In 3, in 2, in 1, let's do it. We still got these niggas fighting in the sky too, dog. I forgot about that. They wasted no time. Hey dog, that was kind of crispy. Memento Mori. I just feel like if you have wings, you're overpowered. That's gotta hurt. I will savor every last moment of tearing your soul to shreds and erasing your existence. It was your fault. You're the one who dragged her into this.
That pitiful excuse of a girl was completely useless. I had such high hopes of utilizing the power of the demons to strengthen the intensity of her magic. But she wasn't ready, and that weakling chose to remain a weakling.
Disrespectful.
Years I've spent teaching you have been wasted. But a place may do what I could not. These woods are filled with vicious beasts. Either they will strip you of your tears, your heart, and your weakness, or they will strip you of your life.
Bro, that's her dad, dog.
Dried for good, you may return.
But she is your own child!
Child, you say?
But how? No. You should be out of power. How can you still be standing?
I told you, I'll keep standing until I put you in the dirt.
No. Stop.
I will have revenge.
Stay back. You've won this. Let me go.
Nakagami? Starlight!
Bro, that feels so long ago. It's her underwear.
She's nothing. The only thing she was ever going to be good for was continuing my bloodline.
Take that back!
He deserved that.
Is that all you've got? You'll never beat me. You need to accept the fact that as long as I'm alive, you'll never have my guild.
We don't want your guild back. We want our guild back. The way it was. When we were a team. The way a guild is supposed to be.
Only the weak believe that crap. A real leader knows the only thing Sabretooth needs is to be the strongest guild there ever was. But you ruined that with your weakness and teamwork.
I know you might see it that way. But I don't. Showing compassion isn't weakness. It's strength.
Okay.
Or unlike anything else.
Speak your mind.
Weakness is abandoning your comrades when they need you the most.
You two believe you could create some perfect guild. There's no way you can, because there's no such thing. And that's just the way it is.
Fairy tale.
Truth is about brute strength and nothing else. Why are you trying to change that?
Because you're wrong. I know the truth now. There are guilds who have it all.
They're strong and kind. They respect each other, and they fight for the good of humanity.
And what a tragic creature you are, for you've never known the light you lack.
And they continue to do it.
Take him down!
That's what it means to be a true guild.
How dare you mock me? One individual's strength is everything. Teamwork is just a clever fallacy. It's made to manipulate the mind and encourage dependence. And nobody is gonna drag me down.
What don't you understand? Things aren't like they used to be. The world is in trouble. We can fix it together. That's how Fairy Tale does things.
As a team.
Never!
Facts, dog.
This is your last chance before we shut you up for good. Let's show them what teamwork can do.
Pushing in the road. How did they get out of that so smoothly? I didn't expect him to go down with that.
Fire dragon!
Ooh, we competing, dog. We competing.
Ice demon rage!
Ice demon rage, dog. Come on now. Yeah. These boys are goated. Greatest duo, dog. The greatest duo in Fairy Tale.
What is up with him? Is he immortal or something?
I just have to get a clear shot to hit him with my magic. Well, humans, I must admit, I've been quite entertained by your attempts to vanquish me. Entertain you with a story about the one and only primordial magic.
Huh?
From that origin point, magic grew to form various distinct paths. END studied this evolution and realized the immense potential for a new kind of power. Curses. Power fueled by the most dismal emotions, woe, spite, envy. Each of these negative feelings gave us an incredibly powerful energy, and we channeled this essence of life to manifest our darkest desires.
Do you even know what you're saying? If that's true, then magic will always be stronger.
Whoa.
Time for the true supreme power to rule. Welcome to the era of curses. Prepare yourselves for purgatory, for I will invoke the ultimate curse designed to destroy Xerath himself. The memory of death.
The memory of death? Yo.
Memento mori.
To kill Xerath, one must destroy the concept of both life and death. Those afflicted by the memento mori no longer belong with the living or with the dead. They simply cease to exist. This can't be the end.
Whoa! That's dark. How would they have lived it, though?
Ultimate curse has finally been perfected and invoked. Once END has been revived, I'll fulfill my promise. And then... you will be destroyed, Lord Xerath.
Nah, I got questions. Hold on, dog. I got mad questions. Bro, hold on. So, that was the ultimate curse to kill Xerath, right? And if... how would have Gray survived it? I understand Natsu, because, again, I'm wholeheartedly believing that Natsu's END. So once END is awakened, Natsu will just come back. But what about Gray, Doug? What about Gray? I guess Natsu could have put some type of protection over him last minute. Nah, Doug, that's way too hard, Doug. You know who made this fight a piece of the cake? Whoa, you know who made this fight a piece of cake? Gildarx, please bring back Gildarx, Doug. I'm so sad not watching Gildarx fight. It is so annoying. Because, like, this would be the perfect fight for a Gildarx-esque character. And then Gildarx gets, like, because he's so beaten up and bruised, that now he goes down. Now Gray and Natsu fight. It just makes more sense, Doug. I don't know. Anyways, let's jump on the next episode. The boy's just been vaporized.
That nigga dead. That nigga passed out. He definitely passed out.
I found you worthy of my greatest curse. Consider it an honor.
I. What the hell?
Your skin. This can't be. No. He's morphed into a half demon. Is this Silver's power? Did that traitorous corpse somehow manage to counter my ultimate curse?
Hey, Natsu. I know I talk crap. Got faith in you. I always have.
He's a half demon?
If anyone can beat him, it's you. Hang in there.
Ain't no fucking way, dog. Dog, Gray gotta be like Natsu every other day. Why she got no clothes on? That's my question. Don't growl at me, Holmes. Blue Pegasus. More help has arrived.
Status report. There's no room for error on a night like this.
Well said, boss. We're on course for the nearest basis. As for the message from Fairy Tale, I have it on a temporary file.
So what now? We await your orders, sir.
The message. Let's retransmit it. Use the communication lacrima. Make sure it's received by every guild in Fiore.
Great idea, sir. We'll need all the help we can get.
At the end of Fairy Tale's message, I'd like you to add the following. The fate of the continent rests on this battle. Gird your loins. As Blue Pegasus' vanguard, we must crush these faces.
Aye, aye, Captain.
You just can't hate Blue Pegasus, though.
Where did those things come from, and what are they?
Were they underground?
All I know is they're creepy. Can't be good.
Mermaid heal.
White towers are the faces from that message. Do you really think they can wipe out all magic?
Time is too short for us to muse on the subject. We must destroy them without hesitation.
Yeah, but where do we even start? There are so many of them and they're gigantic.
First we put our doubts aside, then
all I'm gonna say is they could bring them back, but they couldn't bring back Gildarx. I'm just a hater. But it's been like 5 episodes since this happened.
We did it! Every last one of those faces has blown.
Face on.
Oh,
Someone brought up a really brought up that they did the same thing to Edelus Doug. And I was like, that's kind of fucked. I just thought about that.
This ain't over until I've destroyed E&D.
Right, I forgot. Listen, Gray. I was actually supposed to get a hold of that book for Igneal.
Sorry, but you're not getting it.
Stop screwing around. Hand it over.
I'm serious, Natsu. I'm not letting go. I've got Tartaros's master in this thing. From what they say, he's the most powerful demon out of any of Xerath's books. This might be the only chance we'll ever get to erase him.
All I know is I made Igneal a promise. Now give me the book.
I don't think so.
Neither one of them are wrong, though. That's the thing. Gray's in 100% in the right, and so is Natsu.
Wait. Could this be the faces?
So I don't blame Gray for being like, I'm not going to hand over the book.
So close, but still too late.
I'm scared. I mean, without magic, what'll we do? Will we even be able to talk still?
The screen changed.
Those must be the active faces. This isn't gonna be good.
Wait, so what'll happen now?
The age of magic is over. There's nothing we can do.
Humanity won every last battle, but still we lost the war.
Look, she's falling over.
I just got weak all of a sudden.
Hey, do either of you guys feel like something's missing?
Yeah, my telepathy's gone.
You don't think this means...
Oh!
Somehow.
Yeah, I see that.
Dad, I can't move. What's
Girl,
going on?
Butt hey, naked, dude.
Stay strong.
Ah, damn. What I wouldn't give to be 10 years younger.
Idiot, this isn't an age thing.
This is freaking awful. Losing all my strength is the least manly thing that's happened to me.
That's a great question. Do the Xyz lose the ability to talk? Do they just become cats?
Come on, you need to get up. Real. There's no way.
It seems the time has finally come.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
I don't understand what's wrong. I'm scared. I can barely even move.
Our air is being drained of ether nano. That's how the faces do their work.
What a strange feeling.
Oh yeah, this really affects the world, though.
Could it have something to do with those faces? We can't call for help. The lacrimals are failing.
The entire town's gone dark.
Target acquired. Trajectory set. Better make this.
Other thing, but the fall.
Losing energy.
The great Christina won't be fazed by such a minuscule drain on her magic power. Aim and fire.
Nothing.
Target was unaffected, Chief.
We've only just begun. Ready another. Now fire!
It's nothing, Doug. It's over.
You do realize that this is only the beginning.
Let the book go.
Once all of your beloved magic has been rendered obsolete, the seal that binds my master will finally break. The moment when the mightiest of the Aetherius has been restored, your species will find itself devoid of both magic and any means of opposing us.
No, damn it, no!
Did he just become a...
It's Acnologia.
Oh, I thought he became a human for a second.
Oh.
He's right.
We fired 5 volleys. Why won't they break?
Christina's cannons are the pride of Blue Pegasus, and they didn't even leave a mark.
So should we abort the mission, sir?
Between the cannon shots and the draining ether nano, we've lost too much power. We're about to fall.
So this is how it ends.
You need to move.
Huh? Who was that? Hey, look!
Evasive maneuvers!
No way, Doug! There's no way!
What was that?
A bird? I sense Grandina.
Doug, her dragon's a chicken. Oh, there's Jalal.
Dragon. Thought they died out. Come, we need to hurry.
Grandina. What was whatchamacallit's name? Metallica? Doug, they're dropping.
These are starting to get crossed out.
Does this mean they're destroyed?
Metallicana. Close enough. Ooh, he looks kind of clean.
I know Vyslovia is dead, but somehow I'm picking up on his energy. And I can feel Skiadrum as well.
My kindred are free at last. We soar through the skies of Ishgar once again.
Ooh!
It's a miracle.
There should be 7 dragons. No, Lox is not a real dragon slayer. And neither is Cobra.
Incredible.
Right? Am I tripping? Lox is the Lacrima to make him a false dragon slayer. I can't remember if Cobra did the same though. That's the thing. But everybody else was trained by a dragon. Oh, God. That is by far one of the wildest episodes possible. Gray might be a half-demon. Might be. E&D still has a possibility of being awakened. Every dragon that disappeared 14 years ago is coming back now. It literally feels like the end. It feels like this is the end game of Fairy Tail, but then there's the final season. So I don't know what the hell's happening. Dude, I'm in love. This is amazing. This is by far one of my favorite episodes of Fairy Tail. Maybe even the best episode. Nah, Doug. We still got like a whole slander of episodes. We gonna keep it going. Anyways, it's been your boy, Toon Taylour, here with episodes 261 and 262 of Fairy Tail. If you didn't do it, 262 and 263 of Fairy Tail. My apologies. If you enjoyed today's video, please like. If you're new, please subscribe down below. Link to my social media and my Patreon where you can watch full-length reactions to things like Fairy Tail and others is in the description down below. And I'll see you in my next video. Peace.